Welcome back. In this video, we're going to be reviewing a suite app called Shared Transactions. Now, Shared Transactions basically allows you to take any kind of transaction, generally a bill or a journal entry, and allocate it to any of the NetSuite classifications. So that could be a class, location, department, or subsidiary, or even a custom segment if you have one set up. So for example, let's say you have a bill, and instead of just attributing that to one department, you want to have that split over several departments that use whatever that bill was for. Or you have a situation maybe where one subsidiary has a bill and you want to allocate that to a different subsidiary or even to several locations within a different subsidiary. All of these different things would be available using shared transactions. Now, Shared Transaction is a third-party app. It's produced by a company called NetGain, and they have several other products. However, it is built for NetSuite and lives within NetSuite. So it uses all the standard NetSuite functionality. It's the same user interface, all of that. And I should point out that this video is not sponsored by NetGain. I don't work for NetGain. I don't get paid by NetGain. This is an independent review of the Shared Transactions suite app. And I don't usually make this sort of review video up until now, but it's something I'd like to start doing on a week-to-week basis in addition to the tutorials I usually do. So I'd be reviewing third-party apps, NetSuite features, etc. So if that's something you'd be interested in, hit the like button and let me know in the comments below what product you'd like me to review, whether that is a suite app, a NetSuite feature, or even a situation. Let's say you're looking for a payment processing app and you don't know which one to go with, I could make videos that cover all of these different things. So without further ado, let's take a look at shared transactions in NetSuite. So I'm here in the home dashboard, and the first thing we're going to do is take a look at just a generic bill and how this would apply. So I actually have a bill pulled up here, and I'm currently in a NetGain demo account. So if you're wondering why it might look different from your setup, it's kind of customized for their products. So if we're taking a look at this bill, we can see this is with the vendor A. Brittles Inc. And we can tell that this was for an amount of $5,400. And this was basically comprised of two line items. One is a fax machine and one is 50 boxes of paper to go along with that fax machine. So we have this transaction. Now we want to do an allocation for this. We want to redistribute this expense. Now there's really four ways you can go about doing that. And the first method I would say is the most common, which is creating a template that does the distribution or the allocation, and you apply that template to the bill as a whole. So let's take a look at that. I'm actually gonna show you all the templates that are available and kind of show you how that looks. I'm gonna come up to this sub tab. Now, one thing I wanna point out is that my screen says share transactions, but when you get the app, it will say NetGain because again, I'm in a NetGain demo account. So instead of having their tab say NetGain, they have all their products. So they simply renamed the tabs. Yours won't necessarily say it that way. So that's just something to keep in mind. So if I come down here to setup, notice we have this shared transaction templates. And if I click on that, I can see the full list of all the templates that are made. Now, if you first get the product, you of course won't have any templates, but I'm gonna open up one of these and just give you a concept of how easy they are to set up. So let's open up this template called 50-50 split. And if I come here, so you can see this is a shared transaction template. So it's not necessarily a template just for a bill or for a journal entry. It can apply to any transaction and it's going to allocate based on what we specify here. And in this case, you can see it's a very simple allocation. It's simply distributed by department. So split between two departments. It's not utilizing, this one is not utilizing any of the other segments. And you can see the weighting is 50-50. Now the weighting can be a little misconstrued. The 50-50 doesn't mean 50% and 50%. It means literally a weighting of 50-50. So if the weighting was 1 and 1, it would be the same thing, right? Because out of a total weighting of 2, you would have half going to sales, half going to administration. The thing that's nice about using that weighting is you don't have to think about percentages and make sure that you're always adding up to 100%. You can simply put in whatever weighting you want to, and it will automatically calculate the percentages based on the total weighting that you have. So now that we've taken a look at an example for a template, and all the other ones have different setups where they're utilizing the other classifications, et cetera. So we can actually come back to the bill and we want to apply that 50-50 split to this bill. So we're gonna go into edit mode down here. And we're gonna go over to this custom sub tab. Now, when you get the app, it will automatically put this feature in custom. If you want to rename it or put it in a different subtab, you obviously can do so. And if we come over here to the left, you can see we have this shared transaction template body. So again, this is the first method, which is applying the template to the entire bill as a whole. So I'm going to click on that and I'm going to come down to my 50-50 split. I could click on this plus sign and actually create a new template for this specific bill, but in this case, the 50-50 split is fine. So I'm going to come down here to save, and the transaction successfully saved. So if I come down here, you can see now, instead of going to custom, we're going to go to the shared transaction subtab that we have here. And you can see right here, this allocations, we can see, remember, it was a 50-50 split. So there's two line items and both got split in two ways. So we have four distributions here. We can see the weighting, we can see the amount, we can see the template that was applied in this particular case. And we can also go up here to the GL impact sublist. And it actually pulls up every single journal entry that was created in the background to do this allocation. So we could click on any one of these dates and actually look at the journal entry and what it's influencing in this exact case. So again, that is the first method. And I would say that's probably the most common. The second method, I'm actually going to go to another bill here. This is an identical bill. It's simply a different version of it. So if I come down here, you can see we again have a fax machine and 50 boxes of paper. So now let's take a look at the second method. The second method is applying the template, not to the bill overall, but applying a different template to every line item, regardless of how many line items you have. So we're going to come back down to edit. And if I scroll down here, you can see right over here in this column, we have share transaction template. This column here, I can select. And in this case, let's say I want to do the 50-50 split just for the fax machine, but I want to have the reams of paper be an overhead allocation. So now I have them split up by line item. So that's the second method. Now the third method, keep in mind, up until now, we've only been dealing with templates. And the concept of a template is that it's a situation or a bill or any kind of transaction you're going to be dealing with on a routine basis. It's going to come up more than once. But what if you come across some sort of bill that is unique, or it is a rare situation? You don't expect to come across this again, and you don't want to make a template for it. This might even be a perfect example. You might not buy a fax machine routinely. It might be a one-time purchase. So you want to do a very specific allocation just for this scenario. So in that case, I'm going to hit OK on this. I'm going to actually cancel on what I just did. And so now I'm in view mode, and I'm going to come up here to allocate expenses. If I click on that, it brings me to the shared transaction worksheet. So this is really doing the same things that you can do in a template, except it is basically, you're not saving it as a template. You're just going to be doing whatever changes and allocations you want to do on the fly for this one particular instance and have that just happen for this. So the way this is set up is at the top here, we have the header level information for the bill. And then down here, we actually have all the line items. So there was only two line items. If there was 10, you would see them all listed here. And when we scroll down further, basically for every line item, we're going to populate down here the allocation for that line item. So if I click on machinery and equipment, now remember, I didn't save what I had done when I did the line level templates. I didn't actually save that. So right now, machinery and equipment doesn't have any allocation. So I can do an allocation. I can either come down here and add a line. And let's say I can do a custom, I want to do a weighting of 20. I can specify the account. I can specify, let's say I want to do departments. I want to do one to development, etc. I can also come up here and I can add a template. So again, just for this line item, I can still do this 50-50 split. And I could modify this further. So I have my 50-50 split here. I also have this development line that I just added, and I can come to the office expense and I can do a separate allocation. So let's say office expense, I want to have that actually go to auxiliary, and I want to add a different template in addition to that with a subsidiary split. So right now I have machinery and equipment has its allocation, and I have office equipment with a completely different allocation, both utilizing completely separate templates as well as slight modifications that I've made to both. And you can get as elaborate as you want to be. Now, this will not be saved. Again, this is a one-time thing. So you're not saving a template. You're simply doing whatever allocation you need to do to handle this particular bill. And that's the third method. The fourth method, if we actually come up here, I'm going to hit cancel. So we're back on the bill itself, and I'm going to go back into edit mode. So the fourth method is really the most similar to native NetSuite functionality, which is that you're going to be allocating each line item to a specific classification in its entirety. It's not going to have any kind of a split. It's going to go 100% to one location. And the way you do that is you come all the way over to the right here, and you can see we have these three columns here for subsidiary, department, location, and then the class column is actually on the far left. And we can actually come to any one of these, and we could select what, in this case, it's subsidiary. So we can select what subsidiary this particular line item is going to be allocated to. Now you might wonder, well, why wouldn't I just use native NetSuite functionality for that? You certainly can, but also keep in mind, if maybe this bill was already saved, it's already been created and it was allocated to a particular department, you have the ability to come in here and you can reallocate it to a different department. So that is something, again, there's more of a specific use case for that, but it is a fourth option for doing an allocation. So a couple other things I want to talk about regarding this. So we now understand how this product can be used, but there's a few other things to think with. And first off is the templates themselves. If you're only ever going to have a few templates, you can probably create them on an individual basis. But if you're going to be dealing with 10 or 20 or more templates, you probably want to import them in and save yourself the work. The way you would do that, you use the usual import CSV setup. If you don't know how to do that, you can watch one of my videos on how to do imports. But the way you would do it is you basically import all the template names first. So they don't have any information for them. That's just the name of the templates. And then you do a separate import that links those template names to the actual information for the template. So you would then include columns for the weighting, for whatever classifications you want them to be allocated to, and all that information can be imported. And then with those two imports together, you have all your templates brought into NetSuite. Another thing to keep in mind that's great about this app is if you're importing a lot of transactions, let's say you, at the end of every month, you're bringing in 100 bills, you don't have to import those bills into NetSuite and then go to every single bill and do the allocations or assign the templates on a bill-to-bill basis. You can actually go to the original CSV import and you can add a column for templates, and you simply specify in that column what you want the templates to be, whether it's a template that applies to the entire bill or a template for every line item. You can do it however you want. And that way, when you bring it in, it simply is already, again, because it's natively using NetSuite functionality, it will just automatically have that distribution and that allocation, and you don't have to do anything further than that. So that's one of the great features for using this shared transactions app. The last thing I want to show you in NetSuite itself is if we come up to shared transactions, so we have this setup. If I click on system setup, this is not something you're going to be dealing with on a routine basis, but certainly when you first set up the app and potentially if you're troubleshooting, this is where you're going to come to really modify the features of this app. And one thing in particular that I want to show you is right here, when we're talking about default intercompany accounts, you're limited to, you can see we have one receivables account and one payables account. So even if you have a massive subsidiary structure, the native NetSuite functionality, it was different in the past, but more recently it's changed so that it is only one receivables account and one payables account. You cannot modify that. So the shared transactions app doesn't give you any additional options. It's limited to what NetSuite already does. You're going to have that one receivables and that one payables account. So that's something to think with. So that's a quick run through on some of the functionality for shared transactions. Now let's take a look at some of the pros and cons of this app. First off, up until recently, there really was no other option. If you had to do some sort of allocation for various segments, you had to rely on this product. Now in September 2023, NetSuite did come out with a product called Transaction Line Distribution. And that is basically a feature that does a lot of similar things to share transactions. However, it is limited. For example, if you need to do allocations for journal entries, you can't do that with Transaction Line Distribution. It also runs using a suite script that basically does the allocations once every hour. So if you need to have something that's more real time and happening as things occur, then you would want to rely on something like shared transactions as opposed to waiting every hour for the allocations to distribute. So that's just something to keep in mind in terms of other competitors for this type of product. Another important point that I brought up at the beginning of the video is the fact that Share Transaction is built to live within NetSuite. So it uses all the native NetSuite functionality. It is not a separate integration. So you don't get all the problems that you can come into when you're using a separate outside integration that's plugging into NetSuite. It just uses the basic NetSuite functionality. So it's great from that standpoint. And when looking at different pricing options, you have either a free version. So if you're a little bit unsure if this is going to be the right product for you, you can always try out the free version and see if that works. In most cases, you'll find that you'd want to upgrade to a paid version because the free version is limited by things like only using bills, etc. And I'll get into pricing in a little bit, but that is an option to save yourself the heartache of purchasing it and finding out that it's not for you. Couple of additional features is the fact that NetGain provides what they call a knowledge base, which is really a repository of information and resources to help you understand how to use shared transactions, as well as maybe insights on how to better utilize your business processes using this tool and the other tools that they have available. The last point is that unlike some suite apps that simply get made and are left alone, NetGain is routinely doing updates and trying to enhance the features of their products. So it often will have new features coming along and improvements being made to the product. So what are some of the cons or the limitations of using shared transactions? I'd say the one that comes up the most is a lot of companies want to have an allocation that's not just weighted by department, but also by headcount. In other words, how many employees are in each department? If administration has 40 and let's say marketing only has 20, they want to distribute in that way. So shared transaction can't natively do that because it's not really able to have the system just check all the employee records and link that to a number. But there is a way to get around that. Basically, what you can do is you can create a template. Let's say it's January. At the beginning of January, you simply do a headcount, you make a template, and you do the allocation by department based on the headcount. And once you have that, you can name that template January. And at the end of the month, when you get into February, you can copy that template and then simply do a quick update, right? Modify it, rename it to February, update the number of headcount per department, and then inactivate the January template. So now you have a February one, you use that. When you get to March, you make a new one, et cetera. So it would take maybe 5 or 10 minutes at the beginning of each month. And as long as you're fine with having it up to date on a month-to-month basis, that is a bit of a workaround for the headcount allocation. And lastly, a lot of people ask if they are able to have an approval workflow that processes these allocations. And the answer is no. It's going to rely on whatever your normal approval workflows are. So it's not introducing any kind of new approval workflow. If you have one, let's say for journal entries, it's going to allow the journal entry to go through the approval workflow. And once it's approved, it then gets allocated. There's not some additional workflow. You can, of course, make a custom workflow to accommodate for that in some way, but it would be something you'd have to do on your own. It wouldn't just come with the app itself. So now let's take a look at pricing. So as I mentioned earlier, there is a free version of the app. There's also a standard version, which is roughly $2,000, and a premium version for $5,000. And the prime difference is the number of templates. So the free version has one available template. You can do 10 templates with the standard, and you can have unlimited with the premium. But the main reason people go with the premium version is the fact that it allows all the different types of transactions. So if you need journal entries and not just bills, then you're going to want to go with that premium version. Or if you're a multi-book company, then that feature is only enabled when you're dealing with the premium version. So that's on pricing. Also keep in mind that the pricing includes, so for those two prices, those are just the annual basically subscription rates. There is, if you go with standard or premium, there is an additional fee to have additional support, not just for the installation, but they'll give you follow-up support for the first month. The support from NetGain is actually quite phenomenal. They've got a really kind of gung-ho young team of accountants, and they're very enthusiastic from a support standpoint and from really getting you to get the most out of the product. So I would say that's well worth the money on that side. And that's it for this review on the Suite app shared transactions. Again, if you found this video helpful, please hit the like button and let me know in the comments below what other app you'd like me to review. And with that, I'll see you in the next video.